Mm-hmm. Isn't it so cute? I want you guys to see some. Look. Isn't that just so adorable? Isn't that just something else right there? He just fell asleep on my leg. It's so cute. Hello, YouTubers. Welcome to my channel. I hope you are doing well today. Well, the Queen is angry. The Queen is angry. She's not happy. I feel sorry for the Queen. She has to go through so much and has to still carry herself in a very dignified kind of a way. I can tell you now, if I had to go through all of the things that the Queen is going through, I'd lose my mind. People, they would know, don't go near her. She's having a breakdown. They would know, oh, you don't go over there. You know, she's losing it, y'all. She's losing it. She's getting ready to go just strip all her clothes off and run naked in the forest. Y'all better leave that girl alone. She's mad. She is mad. Because I know I would not be able to contain myself. And that is my biggest problem, because when I get mad, and that's not good. That's not good. I'm speaking about the American form of mad, meaning angry, upset, and about to lose my everlasting mind. You know, you got to learn how to, you know, okay, I'm dignified. I'm dignified, and I don't lose my mind and go crazy when people acting a fool. The princess in the press, royals upset over upcoming BBC documentary. Yeah, it's really coming down, if you know what I mean. I watched it. I'm not sure if you guys watched part one. Part two is going to be out next week, but it really is a doozy. And we're going to talk about it. The royals are uniting. They're like, okay, we got to bring our households together. We've got to come together, and we have got to unite in our fight against the BBC. The BBC. Now, I remember when I lived in England, I had to pay a fee to watch television. That was like the craziest thing ever for me. It's like, what? I gotta pay to watch television? Are you serious? For real? For real? No. What? It was all foreign. But I didn't go out protesting in England and saying, this is absurd. Why do we have to pay to watch the television? The telly? Why? You know, I'm in a foreign country and I just do what I have to do. And perhaps, just maybe, Meghan Markle should have done that when she came into the royal family, because the girl act like she didn't know nothing. She had no idea what the royals were going to be like. It was just all like, they just flipped the script. One day they was all loving and caring, and next day, like, it was completely like backwards. What are you talking about, woman? And it's like, if she had even maybe been there for 10 years and then complained, okay, then I'm listening. I'm like, okay, what'd they do? What did those royals do to you, girl, huh? It's been 10 years. I mean, you put up with a lot. You have sacrificed. You put your time in. What did they do? But that's not the case. She went in, had the baby, plop up. Time to switch. Time to call y'all racist, because I'm ready to leave. I'm ready to leave and I need an excuse. And this whole documentary with the BBC is really leaking stories to the press and the inner workings of the press and the monarchy. Like, it's all coming out now. And it really all came unfolded when this woman came into the royal family. Like, if you backtrace it, look at what was going on. The stories that were being talked about before Harry met that woman. And then once she met the woman, what happened? That is not a dig at Meghan to just be hating. That's really looking critically. Well, where did all this come from? Let me get Mr. Otis one moment, please. He hears me speaking and then he like wants to come in here. Okay. Ah! Otis, that hurt. Oh my goodness. Okay, say hi to the people. All right, so Okay, sit. So in this upcoming documentary on that aired this week on BBC Two, the royal family have reportedly been banned from viewing it. They did not get first viewing of this documentary to give their opinions, views, you know, what should be in there and what should be taken out. And this was usually the custom that they would do that. But for this reason, for somehow, like the BBC was like, no. The BBC told the Queen, no, you're not going to get to see it. We're going to air it without anyone knowing anything. And I guess the Queen was like, what? What? This is absurd. She's not liking it. Okay, so the film is presented by BBC's media editor, Amol Rajan, who has previously been described the monarchy as absurd. So we already see that the person that is producing this is someone who is not really a monarchist. He's really like thinking, y'all folk, y'all crazy, y'all absurd. I'm going to do a documentary about it. And I'm not going to let you have a viewing of it before it's aired. So that should be a clue right there. Like, that should be a big clue. So according to multiple reports, the palace concern may stem from the documentary's premise, which will provide context for William and Harry's relationship with the media. And the two-part doc covers the years leading up to and including the engagement and the marriage of the Duke and the Duchess of Sussex. Yes. All right. Now, keeping in mind, a lot of the interviews in this documentary were done a while ago. They are scrambling, putting together bits and pieces of this documentary and including new information, footage from the Oprah interview to really kind of bring in more context of what has happened over the last couple of years. But just so that you are aware of that. Okay, so the Queen, Prince Charles, Prince William, and Kate Middleton are said to have joined forces to boycott the film. So they're joining forces. They're coming together, all of their households. So this is really good. Well, you know, when I watched it, it was for me just fascinating because I got to see how the inner workings of the press works with the royal family. And they've all joined forces to boycott this documentary because they are not happy. They are upset about this. So despite this, the BBC has not been swayed to share the contents of the film. Despite several meetings with the Duke of Cambridge's advisors and with those of the BBC, they have not been able to come together for an agreement to really have a coming to Jesus moment and work it all out. It appears that the BBC does not want to give the royal family or their aides an advance viewing of this documentary. They are, and I'm not surprised because the guy who was behind it, he's doesn't like the monarchy. You know, he's anti-monarchy. He thinks it's absurd. Quote, it's absurd. It's all about their image, right? They want to protect their image. And it's really no different. If you go back to why Meghan doesn't speak to her father anymore, it's no different than what Meghan's father did when he tried to have his image not look so negative as it had looked. He has no big machine behind him to help him with that. But this is why his daughter is not speaking with him. But yet Meghan and the royal family, they all do it too. They're all controlling their image and setting up different pieces to make themselves look in a good light. But yeah, we're to believe that what her father did is so egregious that I don't want to talk to you. Go figure. It doesn't make sense, right? Apparently, the Daily Mail is quoting the Queen and saying that she is upset that she and others were not able to view the tittle-tattle documentary before it airs. Now, the BBC has so far remained tight-lipped on the documentary and refuses to comment about it, considering that there have been complaints by the royal family. Like, the royal family are really upset and not like, what's going on with you, BBC? Why are you acting like this? Why? You know, and BBC is like, I ain't saying nothing. And you're not going to get to see it beforehand. How about that? And everybody's just mad. It's like, what is going on? It's just gone crazy up there in the royal family. And once again, we know how it all got started.
So I find this part interesting. So the publication also notes that this could be due to last minute edits to include the Duchess of Sussex, her apologies for misleading the court over her level of authorization for the biography Finding Freedom. Her misleading the court sounds so like, there was a little accident made, and she slightly misled the courts there. But you know, things will be much better moving forward. Yes, this was just a little slight little hiccup. Wrong. No, it was not. It was lies. That's what it was. And it ain't gonna be misrepresented as something a little, sorry, it was just a little slight little hiccup there. She gave her apology and all is well, you know. No. It's deep. It's real deep. And it's a lot of bad behavior on the girl who has started all of this. Their behavior is contributing to this madness. The program is about how royal journalism is done and features a range of journalists from broadcast and the newspaper industry. The controversy over the latest royal documentary follows a previous intervention over the documentary Harry and William, What Went Wrong? For the ITV doco air, the channel removed a clip where royal biographer Omid Scobie claimed that Prince William leaked a story to the press about Harry's mental health. Wow. Now, you know, Omid could just be saying that. He really could. Would Prince William really leak a story about his brother's mental health? Or perhaps would it be leaked to portray him negatively? Or could it have been releasing information about Harry's mental health so that people could show sympathy? Like, in what context was it even released? But the fact that they took it out, it really makes it show, or makes it appear that they didn't want the lines blurred. They just said, take it out. But when I see that, or when I hear that William allegedly did that by Omid, I have to question, first of all, if it even happened because of who's saying this. The documentary comes at an interesting time for the BBC, who this year was embattled with an independent inquiry into Martin Bashir's infamous interview with the late Princess Diana. And so we all know what happened with that. And that was just nasty, ugly, nasty, how he went and just lied about the context of why Diana should be speaking with him. It just was so horrible that she was made to believe things that were not true in order to get her to even give up her security and to, you know, meet with him, Mr. Bashir. She thought that people within her household were leaking information and doing things that she couldn't believe. And she thought there was this big conspiracy against her, and they created the BBC, well, on behalf of Martin Bashir, created these false documents. Like, they went all in on the lie. Like, even creating documents to prove their lies. That is so unbelievable. I mean, I can see how Otis, see what you doing? He like half lying down, his butt up and his head down, like, dog. It's terrible how everything has gotten so drama filled. And I can see people really wanting to get rid of the monarchy. Just be like, just get rid of it. It's causing too many problems. But the work that they do is really good. So I don't know. It's really hard balance to find. The royal family is battled in a lot of just negative divisiveness, and it's causing stress to their households. But you have to admire that through it all, the Cambridges, Charles, Camilla, you know, the rest of the royals and the queen, when she can, are still doing the work to help those in the community and bringing attention to nonprofits. But behind the scenes, there's a lot going on. And I will have to talk a little bit more in depth about the documentary when part two comes out, because that's going to really be the deciding factor for me as to what I'm thinking about this whole documentary. Because the one thing that I did see that was really shocking was how they went through great lengths to really dig up information on you, things that you're not legally allowed to publicize or to put out there, but that they would do it, these journalists, and put it out there for the whole world to see, or how they try to manipulate different sides of relationships. It's like, why are we here? Why are we in this position right now? Have you guys ever looked at how this all began? Because it really hasn't stopped since Harry and Meghan have come together in union. Like, this stuff wasn't really going on like at this level. Like, there were different things going on, like with Prince Andrew. Prince Charles had some controversy in there because at this point, really, Meghan needs to just go to sleep, disappear just for a little bit, because it's just getting worse and worse from here. It can only get worse from here. Yet again, the twisting and turning of everything is just like, you know what? I just feel like just throwing up a bunch of papers and saying, you know, just forget it, y'all. Just forget it. Harry and Meghan, y'all just need to stop. Please, just stop it.